Yo, what's up guys? CZ Collector here, and I'm back with another G.I. Joe review. This time we have the Cobra Shock Trooper from the Pursuit of Cobra line. Definitely my favorite line out of all the G.I. Joe lines. Let's give you a quick 360 of this guy. Very, very cool. So now let's check out all the accessories he comes with. So these are all the accessories you get with this figure. You get a... I think this is a... AK, yep, really cool, real tactical looking one, really nice MP5, really, really cool sledgehammer. Get some sweet poses out of this. Get these combat shock sticks, I'm pretty sure is what they are. They unclip and pretty dope. And the best accessory is this really, really awesome riot shield. Alright, let's have a look at the figure. So here he is. Give you another 360 of him in this better light. Of course, the vest is removable. There's a few other accessories, like the helmet that I didn't mention because I wanted to show you them in better detail. But the helmet is three pieces. The goggles come off, as well as the helmet coming away from the gas mask piece. It's on there pretty good. Get out of here. You do have the really cool gas mask piece. It's like a reddy tinge. You can sort of see that's purpley reddy looking color. These have these really cool breathing things on the front, I guess. And yeah, the goggles come off. I've got them blue tacked on because they're really fiddly. They don't stay on. They sit on the top, but they fall off if you sort of move the figure too much. But really cool helmet as well. See the holes through there are what clip into the little clips there on the gas mask. The head underneath, really cool. Not too much movement on the head. Oh well. Another accessory was this walkie-talkie here. Just plugs into a hole on the back there. Pretty cool little accessory. Do like it. I like that it can plug in on the back. So, and it stays on pretty good, so you won't be losing it. Now this tactical vest is awesome. It's the same one that they used on the Cobra Combat Ninja from the newer Retaliation line. It's got the it's really, really good detail on this. It's got the Cobra symbol there. Well, half of it anyway. It's meant to be like a straps going across it or something like that. Has another Cobra symbol on the back there. The word Cobra. Has it again on the side there and on the other side. So we've seen these arms heaps. The Night Viper also uses them. As well as, I'm sure, some other figures as well. None that I can think of off the top of my head at the moment, but they're definitely used a lot. Oh, the Cobra Combat Ninja uses them as well. Okay, going down the figure now to the legs. Again, this is a very reused set of legs. Cobra Combat Ninja uses these as well. But very, very nice. I mean, this is a very sought after figure. People like to army build the crap out of this guy as well, so he does go for a nice price on eBay. He wasn't cheap. So he does have a little bit of black on the knees there and on the boots. Does have his very own named base. Always a good addition. So now let's check out some poses you can get out of this guy with his sweet accessories. Can have him holding his AK. Can have him holding that really sweet MP5. Those really cool combat sticks. You can have him checking into Cobra Commander with his walkie-talkie, with his really cool sledgehammer chilling on his shoulder. Or you can have him beating someone's head in. Now this guy is one awesome figure. Definitely one of my favorites out of all my G.I. Joe figures. He's definitely in the top three. So if you're into G.I. Joes and you don't have this guy yet, I definitely recommend picking him up if you can find him for even $20, $30. I honestly, he's worth it. So pick him up and enjoy the shit out of him, because he has so many sweet accessories. And thanks for watching the review, guys. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.